Baby girl, and by the title of this video, you can see we are doing some baby food prep. Now that my little girl is 9 months old, I am trying to work in more solid foods. I know from what I've read, at least by 10 to 11 months, you really start to give babies 3 meals a day, and mostly containing solid foods as opposed to the purees. Now, I've already started, since she's been about 7 months, I've started including more solid foods. However, I really want to aim for 3 solid foods at each meal. Currently, she gets 5 bottles a day. I do feed her 3 meals a day. Depending on what's going on, I sometimes do the purees, like the puree pouches and stuff, and I do the cracker teethers. However, I really want to aim to provide her really healthy, nutritious meals. And I think by around 10 or 11 months, we're going to drop a bottle. So she'll only be getting 4 bottles a day to help encourage more solid food intake. Just from everywhere I read, that's kind of the transition. So today's video is me just prepping out some meals for her. And hopefully this will encourage you to do the same for your little one. So stay tuned. I'm going to go into everything. You can see I have everything laid out that I'm going to use. First things first, I want to show you my little meal prep containers. So these have 2 sections, and I did not buy a lot, but they're small enough for her foods. I got them from the dollar store, and they were about, I think these were $1.50, and then this 2-pack I think was also $1.50. And they're like the perfect size for the amount of food that I plan on making. I really am not trying to overwhelm myself. It's a very quick, easy meal prep. I'm making hard-boiled eggs and breakfast pancakes, which are only 3 ingredients, banana, oats, and an egg. Hard-boiled eggs for either breakfast or lunch. And then I picked up this Daring Chicken. It's actually plant-based, which I don't have a preference on whether it's meat or not. However, the ingredients look really good. The sodium wasn't too high, and it has 14 grams of protein. So we're going to see how this goes. I'm hoping that she likes it. I was just trying to find something that was clean, and the product details looked good. I just got this from Walmart. So I was going to make her little chicken nuggets and spaghetti, as well as turkey meatballs. And I get the great value from Walmart here. So that will be for meat. So I got 1 meat, and then this one is just supposed to be a plant-based chicken, but it has protein in it. And then I got these little elbow mac and cheese noodles. However, I'm just going to make spaghetti sauce, and I'm going to mix veggies in it. So these veggies are from the brand of Bird's Eye, the ones that you just steam in the microwave. I had some left over, so I'm hoping to mix my sauce and some vegetables together in order to make like a just like a sauce and hide some vegetables in it. I do have the Bird's Eye broccoli. I'm also going to steam up some broccoli for her so she can try some broccoli. I'm going to cook a sweet potato as well and mix it in the sauce, and also have it cubed up as a little side with the chicken. So I'm really only making, I think, 4 different meals, and I'm hoping that this will last me a couple of days. She's really not eating too much. She's mostly playing with the food and putting some up to her mouth. So I'm not going to stress myself out and make a big elaborate meal prep. This should suffice for right now. So let's get started, and I'll show you how I mix everything together.
All right, first I am going to preheat the oven for the sweet potatoes. Now I'm just boiling the eggs and getting the water to a boil for the pasta noodles. My plan for the sweet potato is to cut it in half and then puncture some holes in the sweet potato cover it in aluminum foil and place it in the oven for about 40 to 45 minutes. For the pancakes, I am using oat flakes as my flour. So I am going to blend them up and use that for pancakes. What you need for the pancakes is an egg, a banana, and those oats that we just blended up. And we're going to mix that together in a bowl. So I am making turkey meatballs, and in this pot I am putting in sauce and the turkey meatballs. I feel like they are softer this way for her to chew. I will explain in a little, but these chicken or fake chicken nuggets did not turn out well.
Alright, so update. Those plant-based chicken nuggets were terrible. I had a bite of them. They were not good. So we're going to get rid of that from the meal prep. I did bake some chicken for me and my husband earlier this week. And I'm just going to shred that up and make it like a shredded chicken for her. And I'm probably only gonna use like half of one chicken breast, and that will replace the chicken nuggets I just did, because I will not feed her those. Those were disgusting.
So with boiled eggs, I saw this tip online, but if you put them in an ice bath for like 5 minutes, they are easier to peel. So that is what I'm doing here. All right, guys, things are coming together despite the no-go with the plant-based chicken nuggets. So I have my shredded chicken for her that we're gonna do instead. I have the hard-boiled eggs, we have noodles, and we're still gotta make the sauce, but these are my pancakes for her. This one was perfect. The other one's got a little burnt because I was doing too many things at once, but these are the banana oat pancakes. And so everything's looking good so far. The meatballs are all done. I just turned those off. Not all these meatballs are for her. She's probably gonna get four, and then I'm going to put a little bit aside for us. And the sweet potatoes are done, and they're perfect. So one of these is gonna go for the sauce, and the other one I'm gonna cut up into cubes, and that will be something that she can also kind of feed herself with. So we're gonna get started on that, and I am making quite the mess. For the veggie pasta sauce, I am blending together sweet potato, these steamed vegetables, and I add just a little bit of sauce to help give it some liquid. That way it blends up nicer. And then this is all going to be mixed in with those pasta noodles. All right, so that is the veggie pasta sauce that we're gonna mix in with our noodles. And look how much I still have left of this. So I can still try to maybe feeder some of these if I mash them up pretty good, which is great. So here we go. The broccoli is steamed. I'm just going to drain it of the water, put some butter, pepper, and like a pinch of salt. And then I'm going to cut this bottom half off the broccoli just so it's the head, and kind of chop that up in nice fine pieces for her to eat. And then we are going to box our meal prep. But everything is coming together pretty nicely. This is the part of video that I appreciate the most. It's so nice to see all my hard work displayed out like this and everything packaged up, nicely organized, so that it just makes my life a little easier when I'm trying to feed my baby. Just be able to grab what I want, throw it in the microwave, heat it up for her, and let her just feed herself, explore new textures, new foods. And this is just the way we're going to try to do things. Now, this is the next day. I am just going through what I fed my little girl all day with the meals I prepped for her. I would say she probably ate about like 50 to 75% of the meals. And she did really well, and this is just her enjoying what I did for her. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, and you can hit that subscribe button to follow me. Thank you.